He's back. And this time, he's mad. Gandhi 2. No more Mr. Passive Resistance. He's out to kick some butt. This is one bad mother you don't want to mess with.
Don't move, slime ball.
He's a one-man wrecking crew. But he also knows how to party.
Give me a steak, medium rare.
Hey, Baldy!
There is only one law. His law. Gandhi 2.
Insane. You broke my will, but what a thrill. Goodness gracious, great balls of fire. I let you love what I thought it was funny. You came along and wooed me, honey. I've changed my mind, this love is fine. Goodness gracious, just great balls of fire. Kisses the baby, feels good. Hold me, baby. Well, love you like I love a shoe. You're fine, so kind. Got to tell this world that you're mine. I choose my nails and I twiddle my thumb. I'm real on earth, but it sure is fun. Come on, baby, it drives me crazy. And this drink is just great balls of fire. Feels good. Hold me, baby. Well, I often love you like I love a should. You're fine, so kind. Got to tell this world that you're mine. Ain't you my nails and I twiddle on my thumb. Real nervous, but it sure is fun. Come on, baby, drive me crazy. Goodness gracious, it's just great balls of fire.
Where's the spatula?
Okay, kids, let's go.
There's just one place to go for all your spatula needs.
Spatula City!
Spatula City! A giant warehouse of spatulas for every occasion. Thousands to choose from in every shape, size, and color. And because we eliminate the middleman, we can sell all our spatulas factory direct to you. Where do you go when you want to buy name brand spatulas at a fraction of retail cost?
Spatula City!
Spatula City! And this weekend only, take advantage of our special liquidation sale. Buy 9 spatulas, get the 10th one for just 1 penny. Don't forget, they make great Christmas presents.
And what better way to say I love you than with the gift of a spatula?
Spatula City!
Spatula City!
Hello, this is Cy Greenbloom, president of Spatula City. I like their spatulas so much, I bought the company.
Spatula City, 7 locations. We're in the yellow pages under spatulas.
My, where did you get that lovely spatula?
You have an awesome butt, Nathan.
I say it smells like urine in here.
Thank you. side. Across the sea into my soul. It reaches into where I cannot hide. Setting my feet upon the road. Heart is old, holds my memories. My body burns a gem like flame. Somewhere between the soul and soft machine is where I find myself again.
Okay, stop now. Here's the whole thing. I want you to pull your hair up like this.
Okay.
Okay, do it. Okay, that's great. Good. Thank you. That looks crazy.
Okay, what are you doing? I got a great recipe for chocolate chip cookies.
You do? All right.
Okay, if you add one more egg, you make them real soft.
Okay.
And extra chips, they taste great. Try them.
Okay.
Ready? Break.
Break.
What are we doing now?
This is the attempt to steal Mr. Smith's hat for a period of time and return it to him at the rehearsal tomorrow night. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. We'll start out tonight. Right before call time, we will take...
What day is tonight? What day is today?
Thursday...
28.
Okay. Thursday 28th, approximately 6 o'clock in the evening, we'll take from the dressing room Mr. Smith's cuts. At which point we'll take it to the girls' dressing room where they will hide it. And then Beth Rubin will take it home with her. And she goes, all names here, guys, so no show is taking it. Beth Rubin will take it home with her until tomorrow at the call time. Now, in the morning, he will come into the bus and find clues. There are five different clues that he must go to. He will begin up in his seat. He will need to lift underneath the seat. He will then need to lift into the luggage compartment. After that, he will need to lift under the seat rests. And then in Denise Moore's garment bag. And then he will finish in the bathroom, where we will have another hat with the word psych.
No hat.
Saying psych. At that point, he will be told to look at rehearsal that following evening on Friday. He will then go to rehearsal, and Mr. Whitman will place it on his head before playing one of his pieces. Thus, he will get his grasp on the hat back. That's the plan.
Hopefully it works.
Okay, we'll have updates.
Okay. It really sounded good last night. Of course, I was sitting on the side, but... The basses looked much more...
Well, they knew they were singing well.
The people that I could see, I saw a real expression on the face.
Some things I've been waiting for them to do all tour long for.
Oh, yeah. And it really wasn't a surprise. Knowing these people and just knowing where they're coming from and all, it wasn't a surprise.
Older and younger both just...
I mean... The woman I stayed with, who her husband didn't get, so he didn't even come. But one of their boys that sings, they have a community children's choir, and he sings in it. He came with his mom. I didn't know she had a music minor, but she told Johnny when we got home, she said, "You know how critical I am about music."
Just give me that countryside.
New York is where I'd rather stay. I get allergic smelling hay. I just adore a penthouse view. Darling, I love you, but give me Park Avenue.
The chores.
The stores.
Fresh air.
Times Square.
You are my wife.
Goodbye, city life.
Green acres, we are there.
You don't know this one. I can't show you his face, but here's his razor. Wilkinson. Okay.
Okay.
I knew it. The case of the missing hat, cue number one, clue, is what? You might be saying, give me my hat, please, but first you must get down on your knees. When hell freezes over, your knees is underneath, it's underneath something on which we rest. Please remember, this is all done in jest. And my head is freezing.
Where my hat?
Thank you. about this back row?
Is this trash?
Central Experience.
What'd you say?
What is she? She says it's a very sensual experience.
Another satisfied
customer.
At lunch, I'll get.
When are we going to get lunch?
Okay. It is lunch.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm not hungry.
Sometime this evening.
Okay.
Right
this evening.
We have lunch this evening.
Is there the cleaner of the worst cat? I guess so. It must be.
I have no idea. Oh, toys for you, Jody.
Is it over there?
Did you look at her both of them? Ouch. Come on, it's not very long.
Thanks,
on the
God.
Phone. Susan, did you find your purse?
Just helping.
Mm-hmm. Where was it?
Did you
love me
there?
That's where I place my
head. Where would you place your head?
That's the only place I place my head.
There's a lot of seats on this bus.
Yeah, but they said where I place my head.
There's a lot of,
What's the hold up?
Might want to check in
case the person. Okay, read it out loud.
Why?
Come on, yes.
We have this.
What's it say?
What does it say?
But now it's time for you to get fresh. Just look down the president's dress. Woo!
Hubba hubba.
While she's in it?
Did you not dress?
I didn't know.
We can't hear you. Read it louder.
Since you have been naughty, your head is in the body.
What are you doing back there?
Hey, no using that thing.
You can't use the bathroom.
Would you like some help?
Oh, that D, oh, that job.
ladies and gentlemen, Tommy Okun and Mean Joe Green.
Mr. Green?
Yeah.
You need any help? I just want you to know, I think you're the best ever.
Yeah, sure.
Want my Coke? It's okay, you can have it.
No.
Really, you can have it.
Okay.
How do you feel the tour is going so far, Ken?
I think it's been going quite well, yeah.
Yes. What's been your most outstanding highlight of the tour?
That would have to be when Jen climbed up on top of my back.
Really?
Yeah.
Could you elaborate on this experience?
No, I think it's best that we keep this special moment just between the two of us.
Okay.
Okay.
What does it feel like to have my hat back? It feels great. Okay.
How long have you been waiting now for a chance for these excellent acoustics like we're supposed to have?
I'm sorry?
How long have you been waiting for a chance to have these excellent acoustics?
I've been waiting all tour for excellent acoustics.
Okay.
And I look forward to it. Well, if you really want to know the truth, the most disturbing childhood memory I ever had was the time that I got caught in my zipper.
You got caught? How exactly did this happen?
I was in too big of a rush. What can I say now?
Okay.
I still have scars from it.
Well, I grew up during the days of Sandy Koufax.
Oh, that's terrible.
And John Drysdale.
Hold on.
And Walling Boone. And I saw the first game played at the LA Coliseum before Dodger Stadium was built. And so my dream. Oh, hush. You guys in the back, I see that. My dream as a little boy was to be a concert pianist and a Major League Baseball player. I know, it's weird, but I was stupid. And so I fervently practiced baseball.
Baseball or piano?
Baseball.
Both.
Okay.
Yeah.
Both. Okay.
And I saved, and in those days my allowance was something like about 25 cents a week. And so I saved for over a year to buy a baseball mitt. And I finally got my baseball mitts. And I couldn't afford, I know this is so sad, I'm always crying now. I could not afford a baseball. And so my dog had a old beat up tennis ball. And it had teeth marks all over it, and it had dog slobber on it, dried. And that was the ball I learned to catch with. And I used to go out and throw it up in the air high and try and catch it. And eventually I sort of got, you know, my act together. I learned how to catch the ball. And years rolled by, and I became quite proficient at pitching. I practiced and I had a great, what I thought anyway, was a great curveball and a pretty decent fastball. I wanted to beat another Sandy Koufax. and it was time to go to Little League Baseball. And all the kids on my block, almost all of them were Catholic and belonged to a Catholic league. And I went the first day, didn't tell my parents what I was doing other than I just kind of tagged along. And I remember I had cowboy boots on. And I remember it was so hard to run the bases on tryout in cowboy boots. And I remember I slid into third, and I really narded this little kid terrible with my boots. And the coach, and I apologized to the little boy, and the coach said, "No, that's what I want you to do. Very good. Boy, I can tell, you know, you've really been practicing." And they put me in the outfield at first. And
excuse me. Been doing that all through the concert tonight. It's really pathetic. But, you know, when you like get to sing something and just something comes up and you taste it for the second time, it's really kind of sick. Daryl.
No, when you're famous on the show.
Please. Give me a break.
Well, Lee, I have one small question for you. How do you feel about the snow conditions we have happening out here?
I don't like it.
You don't like it?
Reminds me of Alaska.
Alaska. What do you think about this idea that we have to wait for Denise?
Well, could be worse. I don't like it, but we get stalled here for the weekend, that's all right.
Here's where we realize the
Sing we our praises to the Lord.